What is going on, guys? It's your boy Tommy Craig coming at you with another episode of Turn It Up Tuesday. We're here on location at Campbell's Kickboxing. I got my brother, Bobby Jack Hammer Campbell, over here. What is going on?
What is going on, Tom? We are here.
We're here right now.
You know what we're going to talk about today?
What are we talking about today?
I have no clue, but we're going to talk about something.
We don't even know. We're just winging this right now. Turn It Up Tuesday on a Tuesday. Yep. And we don't even know what we're talking about.
So we want to talk about?
I think we should talk about maybe some kickboxing stories. What do you think?
Yeah, let's go. I'm getting bit up by mosquitoes. Let's go.
Mosquitoes are bad out here right now.
Yeah.
All right, let's talk about, how about my second kickboxing fight? I'm going to start off. I'll give you a story first, okay? My second... Hold on.
I checked that text. It might have been
for
a boy.
For the guy that doesn't answer text messages, you got to answer it now.
You just see why. This is why I don't. This is why I got like 200 text messages, because I'm always busy. I looked at it and I'm not gonna respond back to it.
Yeah,
ever.
He's too busy making a Turn It Up Tuesday video right now.
It's Tuesday right now too. You guys wonder.
Right. But yeah, exactly. And we're gonna release it on a Tuesday. So anyway, yeah. I'm gonna start my story. I'm gonna start my second kickboxing fight. Pretty much, I mean, the second time Bobby's cornering, but really. The first real time that you're cornering. So my trainer tells Bobby, listen, you're going to be my second corner man. Here's all you got to do. When Tommy comes back after the bell rings, you're going to put the stool in the corner. Okay? And then when he stands up, take the stool out. That's all you got to do. That is it. Easy job, right? Bobby's got this job down to the T. He's the
like
man.
Like a pro. Like a freaking pro.
Like he's done this 1,000 times. So me, on the other hand,
time, really.
This is my second fight. So again, when your first few fights, you don't know what's going on. Everything's a blur. So after the first round comes back, I'm all hyped up. I sit down. My trainer gives me the water. She gives me a few instructions. I'm like, okay, I'm good. So I stand up, and I'm ready to go again. I'm just ready to go. And I stand up, and he's like, no, you got time. He's like, sit back down, relax. So I go, okay, I go to sit back down. But you know what happened. The second I stood up, I was like, I have one job to do, and I'm going to do it right.
And I did it great.
I did it great.
Yeah. You stood up, stool went out.
Right, I got nothing to sit on. So my instructor pushes me back. I fall down. I almost fell out of the ring. My second fight.
Out of the ring.
I'm hanging halfway out of the ring because Bobby pulled the stool out from me.
August 1st, 1998.
That's when it happened?
Yeah.
Man, this guy, the encyclopedia of kickboxing.
I don't really know the deets anymore, but I remember
But you remember
old
some?
One.
Okay,
I remember
all right.
One. I remember old
well, one. Luckily I didn't get hurt, stood up, can finish the fight, won the fight, good job. We had no more instances after that.
I'm gonna tell you guys a story that's not old. It's actually pretty new.
Ooh,
it's going back to less than a year ago, my last fight. Let me tell you something.
Okay, let's hear it.
I break my nose 10 days before the fight.
I remember this.
Tom's in the corner. My buddy Josh's in the corner. I say one thing to them. Guys, listen. My nose is going to bleed right off the bat. Right off Jump Street. First round, it's going to bleed. The second the guy looks at my nose, it's going to bleed. So what happens? Now I got this beard. This beard is like, it's pretty new. But, you know. So they must be blind as anything. The first punch the guy hits me with, my nose starts bleeding. I get back to the corner, I'm sitting down, and these two guys, I don't know what they're doing, but I'm like, yo, anyone want to clean my nose? And they're like, looking at each other, like, and then afterwards, like, yeah, we talked about it too, who was there cleaning, but then we forgot. Honestly, I gave them one job. I didn't even tell them anything else. Well, actually, that's a lie. I gave him two jobs, and guess what? The other job was how we were going to make the walk to the ring. And guess what? They messed up the walk to the ring.
That was not on me. That one was
two jobs, and both jobs did not go well. It's not that hard.
The entrance was all jacked up.
The entrance was jacked up after we explained 10 times.
Which way? We're walking down. We're going to go this way, around the ring, around the entire ring, go to the red corner. This is it. All right, Bobby, I got it. No problem. We got this. And then you know what happens? When everybody came into the room, Bobby's like, oh, so-and-so, I don't remember who it was, you take the lead, you lead us out, you go in the front. And I'm like, uh-oh, that's not going to be good. That person had no idea where they're going.
The problem is I bring a big entourage, so like you always try not to have an entourage in the dressing room, all of a sudden there's like 30 people in the dressing room and there's chaos.
the chaos.
No matter how many times you plan out how it's going to go, it never goes that way.
Chaos.
Two jobs, two fails.
Yeah. Yeah.
0 for 2.
Definitely miscommunication between with the towel wiping.
Yes. Yeah. That was the only job. It was like the only thing. It wasn't like, yo, between rounds, I want ice on my neck. You know, you got to make sure you tell me the time. No, guys, just make sure you clean my nose because you're going to bleed right off the bat. Round one, no one's there.
And we're not even talking just blood. Yeah, it's blood on your chest.
Give credit. I had a lot of blood on my chest. I don't know what was going on, but Tom's like, I can't get it off. And I'm like, I don't know. I don't know where it's from. I don't know what's going on.
Listen, as a corner man, you want to make sure your guys doesn't look bloody because it looks bad for the judges, right? Yeah. You want to make sure you're looking good, you're looking fresh. That's it. You guys don't realize being in the corner is actually a lot of pressure, and there's a lot of things going on in the corner. People don't realize that's going on.
No, there's a lot going on. And what people don't realize is I wear white pants all the time or white shorts. And now I have this beard, you know, you can't see my nose bleeding. And then I tell people, like, I had the tampons in my nose afterwards. Everyone's like, you bleed? I'm like, did you look at my pants?
The pants are covered. They're not white anymore. They're pink.
The pants are pink. What do you think it's from? This guy and Josh, two fails. Two jobs, two fails.
I'm going to say one. I'm gonna say the other one's not on me.
I don't know.
But it was two fails that night for sure.
There was two fails that night for sure. There was not much, you know, normally it's like, oh, you gotta do. No, it was like, yo, my nose is gonna bleed. Let's make sure it's clean. That's it.
But you know what? You still won the fight?
That's all that matters.
You
gotta get the W no matter what.
That's it.
But if you're wondering, yo, Gary Hamilton, yo, what's up?
I don't know if you guys know the deal with Gary Hamilton, but Bobby's calling him out. The one fighter Bobby never fought, never happened, kept trying to make
since
it happen.
Since
2008.
Now you got two old guys walking in with walkers. We get a fight, though.
It would still be a banger, that's for sure.
Two old men. That's what's up.
All right, so there you go. So there's some quick impromptu kickboxing stories. Wait, you got another one?
No.
You had something else.
I got to teach. Next
lessons are coming up right now. So I hope you guys enjoy these stories. You want to say anything else about Gary Hamilton or anything else?
I got another fight before Gary Hamilton. Tune in for my 40th birthday. We're going to celebrate by getting punched in the face.
And Bobby, what day is that?
Fall 2022. November 20th.
Okay.
It's November 20th. Come out and celebrate my 40th birthday, November 20th. Watch me get punched in the face and watch me punch someone in the face.
And where is it going to be?
Mulcahy's, June 26th. Boom, the announcement gets made who I'm fighting.
All right, so make sure you guys follow Bobby. I'll throw his Instagram up in the description.
Or just go on Mulcahy's. You see the big banner of me versus my opponent to be announced June 26th.
Big banner. Come down June 26th, see the announcement live.
Yeah.
Word. All right, hit me up if you guys want tickets.
Word to your mama.
We're really going
out
of control now. Time to try out.